Tomb Raider has touched the lives of many players across the world. Lara Croft has become an icon, exploding onto the scene on consoles such as the Sega Saturn, PlayStation, and PC back in 1996. With 26 years under its belt, Tomb Raider 1 will always remain a masterpiece of its time. It was one of the first fully 3D games, amazing atmosphere, soundtracks, and puzzles, setting the foundation for games we know and love today. And there are so many in the Tomb Raider community who want to keep the love for Tomb Raider 1 alive. One member decided to write the greatest love letter to the franchise in the form of programming. In 2015, Stohrendorf decided to change the world of Tomb Raider forever. He has created a unique experience for Tomb Raider 1. Today, we're going to dive into the features and tools Croft Engine has to offer. This is KittyPie 3.14, and this is Croft Engine. Now let's swan dive into the features of Croft Engine. Being inspired by OpenTomb, Stohrendorf originally created Croft Engine to experience Tomb Raider on a modern system with enhanced features for modern audiences. It's all the main game, but with so much more. It supports Tomb Raider 1, Tomb Raider Unfinished Business, and Sabatu's Tomb Raider Reimagined. Visuals is one of the biggest selling points for Croft Engine. It is fully customizable to whatever experience you would like to have. Do you want to relive Tomb Raider in the good old PlayStation days? There's a CRT mode. Get in touch with your creative side and utilize the various camera modes: lens distortion, depth of field, film grain, bloom, and Velvia to make your own picture-perfect experience. Indulge yourself on dynamic lighting inspired by the Sega Saturn version of the game. Partial, mostly, and full versions of dynamic lighting to tailor your needs. Speaking about lighting, you can adjust brightness and contrast, toggle muzzle flashes to give it that extra flare, and edge outlines to give it dimension. The quality setting allows you to adjust bilinear filtering, anisotropic filtering, FX anti-aliasing, horizon-based ambient occlusion, and shadow quality, for those who like to be fancy. For that extra kick, you can denoise the water surface and apply smoother animations. The render scale and user interface scale allows those with visual impairments a better quality of life and to be able to play Tomb Raider comfortably. Spice up your game by enabling the extra settings. Other options include playing full screen or windowed mode, having a pulsing health bar to notify you that your health is running low. Modernize your health status by having the game reduce in color the lower your health is. To add more to your atmosphere, add dust particles, waterbed bubbles, and extra lighting. Or get really cheeky and turn butt bubbles on to give Lara a bubbly personality.
Gosh, that was my best yet.
Ghost mode. It's a tool for all style of players, from newcomers to well-seasoned raiders. If you're new, it allows the game to retrace your steps, avoid traps and enemies you've encountered before. If you're well-seasoned, practice your jumps and strategies for speedrunning, racing, or just getting those personal bests. Get a ghost file from a friend or a fellow raider to learn from them in your own time. But if you're really sadistic, you can watch Lara die over and over and over and over again. Streamlined inventory. Lara took the guesswork out of key items. She'll automatically use the key or item needed for the puzzle or door. No more popping in and out of inventory, reducing stress and time for speedrunners, and is a very useful tool to newcomers, especially for St. Francis's Folly. Cheat codes. Taking one step forward, one step back, turning three times, You know the drill. If you jump forward, you'll level skip. By jumping backwards, it enables all weapons. But now, we have two extra cheat codes. If you jump to the right, it'll give you 10 extra med packs, 5 large, 5 small. If you jump to the left, it will cut the enemy's health in half each time you use it. Do it 4 times, it'll bring enemies' health to 1-hit kills. But it does reset at the beginning of each level, so consider yourself warned. Controls. Croft Engine already comes fully equipped with controller support. For most controllers, you won't need a joystick key or X-Pad. You just plug in and play. For those who still like to play with a keyboard, it is fully customizable. You can even play with one hand and drink coffee in the other. I know it's been an amazing ride just looking at how awesome Croft Engine is to creating a unique and dynamic experience for the player. However, I do have one more thing to reveal. Multiplayer mode. This is still a work in progress, but you too can experience the game with friends or fellow Tomb Raider lovers. After registering an account, you will have access to playing online. Choose your color for others to see, your username that you registered with, your personal and private authorization token, and session ID for the game you wish to join. Multiplayer opens up so many doors to the Tomb Raider community. This works for Tomb Raider 1, Unfinished Business, and Sabatu. Actively learn from others who have played the game. Gain tips and tricks from other experienced players. Do a first-time playthrough or finish the game with others around you. Learn maps, find secrets, and gain confidence to play the game on your own. If you've never played Tomb Raider Unfinished Business or Sabatu, request a guide to show you around. Join the Discord to make new friends and voice chat, raise concerns, or compliment the programmers. We look forward to playing along with you. All you'd have to do is download the multiplayer version from haunted.earvillage.net, link in the description below, to register today. Installation. Croft Engine is an amazing addition to any Tomb Raider gamer's arsenal. All you need is a PC, a copy of Tomb Raider, whether it be Steam, GOG, or CD, and the latest version of Croft Engine, found at github.com/Stohrendorf/CroftEngine/releases. Link will be in the description below. The setup wizard walks you through the process and does the majority of the work for you. Then, here you can choose to add your own favorite texture packs too, though some may not be compatible with Unfinished Business or Sabatu. The startup pop-up allows you to choose what Tomb Raider you wish to play and change any non-in-game configurations. The Tomb Raider community is one of the best gaming communities out there, and we are so glad to be able to share this fantastic new way to play Tomb Raider and bring us together closer than ever, and welcome in the newest batch of Tomb Raider fans. We want to thank Storin for his idea and hard work, Shirashima for her contributions to Croft Engine, aiding Storin with coding and implementations, and all those who have joined us in testing. We hope you love Croft Engine just as much as we do. We look forward to seeing you online real soon. On behalf of JStation, Storin, Shirashima, and myself, I'm Kitty Pie 314. Thanks for watching.